these three strange and beautiful umbrella-shaped animals are members of an unusual family of carnivorous sponges called the Cladorhizidae. Most sponges utilize an internal system of canals and specialized cells to pump water through their porous bodies, filtering a diet of bacteria and tiny organisms from the surrounding water. But in the deep sea, food is limited, and much of the life there survives on an irregular supply of organic debris from the sea surface, known as marine snow. Filtering water is metabolically costly, so carnivorous sponges have adapted to their food-poor environment by feeding on larger, more nutritious prey, such as flea-sized crustaceans that they ensnare with tiny hooks. These tiny hooks and other structural components, called spicules, allow us to differentiate one sponge species from all others. The most recent carnivorous sponges to be described are a trio of umbrella-shaped sponges from the Northeast Pacific Ocean. The long main stalk keeps the sponge anchored to the seafloor, yet holds the feeding and reproductive parts high above it, which prevents fouling by soft sediment and drifting debris. Prey is captured in the long, slender filaments radiating in all directions from the umbrella edge. Egg production and development occurs in a swelling on the stalk just below the umbrella. Short filaments or antenna-like discs on the top of the umbrella release sperm in packages called spermatophores. Cladorhiza Ken Smithi is named in honor of marine ecologist Ken Smith of MBARI, whose 40-year career has led to a greater understanding of the ecology and impacts of climate change in extreme environments like the deep sea and polar regions. This species lives in the soft abyssal sediment from 3,200 to 4,000 meters off the coast of California. It attaches to the seafloor with a root-like rhizoid. It was collected during several research expeditions led by MBARI scientists Ken Smith and David Clegg. Cladorhiza hubbsi was described from a single specimen collected by Carl L. Hubbs off Southern California in 1969. Dr. Hubbs was a very prolific fish biologist who had far-ranging research interests, from seamount biology to marine mammals. This specimen was collected before the availability of our modern techniques, so images of the sponge living in its habitat are not available. Cladorhiza mexicana was named after the location where the species was first observed, in deep water off Mexico's Baja Peninsula in the Gulf of California. Unlike the rooted species found in soft sediment, this species was recovered from a volcanic rock, and we believe it was attached with a holdfast disc, which broke off during collection. As we continue to explore and study the deep sea, we find bizarre and often beautiful adaptations to life in this harsh environment, which never cease to amaze. From the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute, this is Lonny Lundsten.